Welcome students, this is the continuation of acoustic chapter. Today we are going to learn about Doppler effect, conditions and applications. Doppler effect. The whistle of a fast moving train or the sound of ambulance appears to increase in pitch as it approaches a stationary listener, and it appears to decrease as the train or ambulance moves away from the listener. So observer, she is the listener. When a fast moving ambulance appears to increase in pitch as it approaches a stationary listener, and it appears to decrease as the ambulance moves away from the listener. This apparent change in frequency was first observed and explained by Christian Doppler, an Austrian mathematician and physicist. He observed that the frequency of the sound as received by a listener is different from the original frequency produced by the source. Here the source is ambulance. Whenever there is a relative motion between the source and the listener, this is known as Doppler effect. So what is Doppler effect? Whenever there is a relative motion between a source and a listener, the frequency of the sound heard by the listener is different from the original frequency of sound emitted by the source. This is known as Doppler effect. This relative motion could be due to various possibilities. They are, the listener moves towards or away from a stationary source. Then the source moves towards or away from a stationary source. So in first possibility, the listener moves. Here the source moves. Then both source and listener move towards or away from one another. Then the medium moves when both source and listener are at rest. So these are the four possibilities. For simplicity of calculation, it is assumed that the medium is at rest. That is, the velocity of the medium is zero. Let S and L be the source and the listener. S is source and L is the listener. With velocities Vs and VL. Vs is velocity of source, then VL velocity of listener. Consider the case of source and listener moving towards each other. Source and listener moving towards each other. Here, as the distance between them decreases, the apparent frequency will be more than the actual frequency. Actual source frequency. So let N and N dash be the frequency of the sound produced by the source and the sound absorbed by the listener respectively. N is the frequency of sound produced by the source. Then N dash is the sound frequency of sound absorbed by the listener. Then the expression for the apparent frequency N dash is N dash is equal to V plus VL by V minus VS into N. Here V is the velocity of sound wave in the given medium. Let us consider different possibilities of motions of the source and the listener. So when source and listener move towards each other, then the apparent frequency will be, that is the apparent frequency N dash will be more than the actual frequency. So these are expression for apparent frequency due to Doppler effect. So in all the cases, the expressions for the apparent frequencies are in case 1. Position of source and listener, that is both source and listener move. They move towards each other. Here, distance between source and the listener decreases. So, apparent frequency is more than actual frequency. So, what is the expression? N dash is equal to V plus VL by V minus VS into N. So, here the distance between the source and the listener decreases. Apparent frequency is more. So, when distance decreases between the source and listener, apparent frequency will be more than the actual frequency. Then, case 2. Here, both source and listener move. That is, they move away from each other. So, here the distance between source and listener increases because they move away from each other. So, the apparent frequency is less than the actual frequency. Apparent frequency is less when the distance between the source and the listener increases. So, the expression N dash is equal to V minus VL by V plus VS. So, here in case 1, V plus VL, both source and listener move towards each other. So, here source and listener move away from each other. So, the direction is opposite. So, by changing the sign of listener velocity, so V minus VL by V plus VS. So, here in case 1, here the sign is negative, here it is positive. So, by changing the signs, so we get this expression. Then in case 3, both source and listener move, that is they move one behind the other, that is source follows the listener. So, here the apparent frequency depends on the velocities of the source and the listener. That is Vs, velocity of source, becomes opposite to that in case 2. So, in case 2, velocities of source is in different direction. In case 3, it is in opposite direction. So, the expression is N dash is equal to V minus VL by V minus Vs into N. So, by changing the sign for velocity of source, so it becomes V minus Vs in case 3. In case 4, both source and listener move. Here, they move one behind the other. The listener follows the source. So, here listener follows the source. So, here apparent frequency depends on the velocities of the source and the listener. So, Vs and VL become opposite to that in case 3. So, the direction opposite to that in case 3. So, the expression N dash is equal to V plus VL by V plus Vs into N. So, by changing the sign negative into positive, we get V plus VL by V plus Vs. So, in this case, velocity of source and velocity of listener become opposite to that in case 3. Next, case 5. Source at rest, listener moves towards the source. So, here the distance between source and listener decreases. So, the apparent frequency is more than actual frequency. So, when distance decreases, apparent frequency is more. Here, source is at rest. So, the velocity of source is 0. So, the expression is N dash is equal to V plus VL by V into N. So, Vs becomes 0 in this case. So, we get V plus VL by V into N. Then in case 6, source at rest, listener moves away from the source. In case 5, listener moves towards the rest, so towards the source. Here also source is at rest. In case 6, source at rest. So here listener moves away from the source. Here the distance between source and listener increases because L is that is listener moves away from the source, so the apparent frequency is less. So when distance increases, apparent frequency is less. Here velocity of source is zero because source is at rest. So the expression is n dash is equal to v minus vl by v. So in case 5, v plus vl, so by changing the sign we get v minus vl because here the listener moves away from the source. Next, case 7, listener at rest, source moves towards the listener. So the distance between source and listener decreases. So distance decreases, apparent frequency is more. Here listener is at rest, so velocity of listener is 0. So we get expression n dash is equal to v by v minus vs in case 1. Then case 8, here also listener at rest, source moves away from the listener. So distance between source and listener increases. So when distance increases, the apparent frequency is less than actual frequency. So here also velocity of listener is 0 because listener at rest. So we get the expression n dash is equal to v by v plus vs into n. Suppose the medium is moving with the velocity w in the direction of propagation of sound. So for this case, the velocity of sound v should be replaced with v plus w. If the medium moves in a direction opposite to the propagation of sound, then v should be replaced with v minus w. Then conditions for no Doppler effect. So there will be no Doppler effect and the apparent frequency as heard by the listener will be the same as the source frequency. When source and listener both are at rest, when source and listener move in such a way the distance between them remains constant, then when source and listener are moving in mutually perpendicular directions, then if the source is situated at the center of the circle along which the listener is moving. So under the following circumstances, there will be no Doppler effect and the apparent frequency as heard by the listener will be the same as the source frequency. So there is no Doppler effect. Next, applications of Doppler effect. To measure the speed of an automobile. An electromagnetic wave is emitted by a source attached to a police car. The wave is reflected by a moving vehicle which acts as a moving source. So here there is a shift in the frequency of the reflected wave. So from the frequency shift, the speed of the car can be determined. This helps to track the overspeeding vehicles. Then tracking a satellite. The frequency of radio waves emitted by a satellite decreases as the satellite passes away from the earth. By measuring the change in the frequency of the radio waves, the location of the satellite is studied. Then radar, radio detection and ranging. In radar, radio waves are sent and the reflected waves are detected by the receiver of the radar station. From the frequency change, the speed and location of the aeroplanes and aircrafts are tracked. Then sonar. In sonar, by measuring the change in the frequency between the sent signal and received signal, the speed of marine animals and submarines can be determined. So these are the applications of Doppler effect. Students, hope you all understood about Doppler effect, conditions and applications. Thank you.